I so remember how I was thinking of talking to you about things that you should have before getting a pup. So this is going to be a video on that. And if you are a new pet parent or planning to get a puppy home, so stay tuned and watch till the end. So here I am. So a few weeks back, I had made a video about things you should know before getting a puppy home. So I'll link down below in case you've missed out on that. And let's get into this video where I'm gonna help you out with things that you actually need when you get a pup home. So number one is a bed. So just like we have our own beds to lie down, I think that's a little space that you can get for your puppy. And make sure you get a size that'll work on for a year or maybe more. We got a large size bed and hopefully it should work for Zoro for about maybe 1.5 years. And after that, we'll see what has to be done. So yes, number one is a bed for the. Number two, you have to have your vet or any kind of pet clinic close by, or someone you can go to, because the vaccination will be starting up for your puppy. So you have to make sure you have budgeted for the vaccination. For us, it took us about 6,000-ish for 1 year. Third is a water and a food bowl. So I initially got a plastic one because I didn't know how much to feed him, and I knew I would have to buy a bigger bowl once he grows up. So I got a plastic bowl, and thank God for that, because when he was teething, he would run around with the bowl, chew on the bowl, and I think if it would had been a ceramic or a melamine one, it would have hurt him. So yes, so food and water bowl is a must. Number four would be a blanket. When we got Zoro, it was pretty chilled. The climate was cold and he would like curl up and sleep in his bed. So that is when we decided to get a blanket. So what I got was a baby blanket, which is very thin. It's like a summer blanket, just for a cover up or a base on the bed. Number five would be the dog food and dog treats. Usually the doctor suggests not to give puppies treat, but then we had to train him. So after about 30 days, we started giving him treats, and then we started with kibble from Farmina, NND Farmina. But then meanwhile, we also started giving him home-cooked food with veggies and some meat and eggs and rice and other grains, whatever we had. You can also give him dal, other than chana dal, I think you can give the other two. But please do check with your vet regarding the diet chart, because they will know better. Once we diligently heard, listened to our vet, and we gave the food according to whatever the doctor told us to, because we had to give him supplements of vitamins and calcium and immunity boosters too. So that went on for quite some time. So yes, dog food. Do your research well. See what you want to feed, what you don't want to feed, because the moment you start feeding him from initial days, he will never have a hate towards a particular dish. I think as of now, Zoro eats everything and anything, maybe because he's a puppy. But yeah, so what we are giving him now is a mixed vegetable of carrot, beans, soya, pumpkin, papaya, spinach, and what else? I think I'm missing out on something, but yeah, that. Sometimes chicken, sometimes I get him dog food from some of the pet shelves around the city. Yeah, so you can check that out also. In case of emergency, you can just get dog food from places that makes dog food, and in Bangalore there are a lot, thankfully. So yeah, so number six would be dog toys. So in the initial age, they will be teething a lot, because of which they will try to bite into everything. So for that you can get some rope toys, some plush toys, so that they can just keep nibbing on it and feel satisfied during their teething period. So yes, dog toys is a must have, especially a small ball that makes a noise, because that's the curiosity they all have. Number 7 would be puppy proofing your house. Thankfully our house, we don't have anything on the table or on the floor that can be eaten away or destroyed by this little monster. So yeah, so puppy proof is a must, because you can't have wires going around the house and still ask the puppy not to be curious about it and bite into it. So make sure your house is puppy proof. So next on the list would be a crate. Although I don't implement crate, I haven't gotten a crate for Zoro, because I didn't want that cage kind of training method to be used, but a lot of people like that. So if you wish to train him that way, him or her that way, you can go ahead, get a crate. Ninth on my list would be the grooming products, which would help you clean your puppy after a mud play or a mud bath, whatever you might call it. So you need to be ready with your grooming products. There are home remedies used to clean a puppy, so you can try that out as well. And make sure you have a collar for your dog, and also make sure you have a tag which has your number and the dog's name on it. And so initial few months we never used a leash on Zoro, because he was too tiny, and it would just make it very difficult for me and him to walk around. So we decided to get a leash only after 2 months. We started training him with leash. So make sure you have a leash ready, and collar is a must have. We also added a bell kind of thing that rings every time he walks, because so that we know where he is in the dark. That is up to you. A lot of people say that puppies are very sensitive to sound at that age, so they recommend you not to have that bell. But the NGO already had a bell to Zoro, so we kept that bell to his tag, and now we know where he is. These are the most important ones that you must have if you're getting a puppy. And yeah, so if you have any other questions on it, you are free to write to me on my email ID. Everything is mentioned below, or you can just leave me a comment and I'll reply back. I'm happy to hear from you guys. So yeah, so this is me signing off from this video. I'm Anusha, the small town blogger, and if you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe.